We have a group of 4 students, and they're very, very motivated about blockchain. As their professor, I was inspired to explore a new technology. Brazil is a country in which there are trust issues. We don't trust the government or businesses. Companies and governments don't trust each other. So when things go wrong, they sue each other because they don't do what they claim. One may be fined for something they didn't do for political or corruption reasons. We wanted a system that verifies and ensures that everything follows the contract, without a centralized person who could declare, "You're incorrect." This became our first project. So we're developing 2 different apps. One is focused on privacy, and the other one is focused on enforcing that public goods work the right way. In this case, bus itinerary schedules. Let's start with the public goods application. It's done in a decentralized way so that anyone can check that the bus has actually arrived at the right place and time, or that they didn't, right? And the other one is basically a way for you to have more transparency on how your data is being stored, used, and it's enforcing privacy. So in Brazil, you have these public routes established for a ferry boat or a bus line or a train line. The government sets the maximum price per itinerary for private organizations to execute specific lines. But some lines are more lucrative than others. A short line with many passengers is more profitable than a lengthy line with few. So the companies say, okay, I'll concentrate on this popular route during commuting hours, and I won't take it around midday because I don't want to waste gas on a bus with only 2 or 3 people. So the passengers are waiting for a bus that never comes. But often the government cannot prove this. With our application, the chosen itineraries are clear and transparent, and the public can actively make the application better by telling if the bus showed up or not. On this public transportation system, we have an oracle problem, which is the problem of having some input that the blockchain cannot validate by itself, this being the positioning of the vehicle. But on the blockchain, there are a couple of solutions for this, especially in combination with the Internet of Things. IoTeX, for instance, solves this by having hardware that is audited in the real world that generates decentralized data safely stored on the blockchain. When the device sends data to the system, you can check the signature and check if it's one of the audited devices and have more trust in that reading. You see, oh, this bus X with the Y device aboard is riding route A. In case of a traffic jam, which will cause a delay and the bus is standing still, for example, we can check for inconsistencies using other data sources. For instance, cross-referencing with existing apps like Waze or Google Maps or any other live navigation and traffic apps, or with readings from other devices. The Internet of Things becomes the Internet of Trusted Things. We are developing with Python on the back end of the Cartesi machine, and for the front end, we're using JavaScript with React. On the back end, we're also using SQLite. It's a database that can be embedded as a library on the blockchain OS. This is not possible without the OS. If we want to connect to a database on other blockchains first, we wouldn't have the database. We would have to rewrite the library. We wouldn't have the string concept. It'd just be bytes. So the OS offers magnitudes of higher abstraction and, for the developer, a much easier way to get much faster results. It's like ordering a fried egg in a restaurant. That's a high-level order. If ordering on a lower level, you have to say, "Now go to the fridge, open the fridge, look on the right, pick up an egg, take out the egg," and so on. The moment we have our solution ready for the bus monitoring system, there's a chance it will actually see the light of day, that the government might indeed adopt this solution. At our university, the City Hall and the university work very closely on many projects. Since the OS with its rollups technology can solve scalability issues, we can also think of ways to integrate bus ticket payment over blockchain in our app. Payments on the blockchain can take like 10 minutes to compute now. Waiting 10 minutes for a payment for a new house is okay, but waiting 10 minutes to buy a bus ticket? That'll never work. That's why the rollups technology is essential.